Hello friend, in the last video we have discussed about the conflict serializability. In this video we will talk about view serializability. Okay. Now what is view serializability? If a given schedule is found to be view equivalent to some serial schedule, then it is called a view serializable schedule. Okay. That means say two schedules are there, A's and A's dash, and if both are view equivalent, both are view equivalent to some serial schedule, then it is called a view serializable schedule. Now if both are view equivalent and if S dash is the serial schedule, then you can say S is the view serializable schedule. Okay. Now how to check whether they are view equivalent or not? Now the schedule S and S dash to be view equivalent if the following three conditions are met. Now we have to check three conditions whether they are view equivalent or not. So the first condition is what? If transaction TI reads the initial value of Q in schedule S, then transaction TI must in schedule S dash also read the initial value of Q. Okay. Next, if transaction TI executes read Q in schedule S and then value was produced by transaction TJ, the another transaction, then transaction TI must in schedule S dash also read the value of Q that was produced by transaction TJ. For each data item Q, the transaction that performed the final write, remember this one, final write operation in schedule S must perform the final writes operation in schedule S dash. Okay, so we have to consider these three points only: initial value, okay, and the read this one, reading the S value that was produced by the other value, okay, and the final write. Now you can see one example. Okay, so we have to consider these three: initial read, final write, intermediate read must follow the write. Okay, now we can see, check whether these two schedules are view equivalent or not. Now what is the initial read? Initial read of A variable, that is by T1. Okay, initial read that is by T1 for A, and for B variable also it is T1. Now we have to check whether it is same T1 or not. Now here the initial read by T1 of A variable by T1, and for B variable it is also T1. So in both the cases, initial value read A and B variable T1, A and B variable T1. Next, final write. So the final write of S variable, it is given by T2. This is what our final write. Final write of A variable and final write of B variable, both by T2 transaction. Now you can see final write. So final write of A variable, this is this one. Okay, you can see this one. So final write, this one, and final write of B variable, that is the one, and that is also given by T2. So you can see initial read is by S, it is T1 both for both A and B variable, and in S dash also by T1 both A and B variable, and final write in S both T2 for A and B variable, and in S dash also it is T2 A and B variables. Now you can say intermediate read. Now you can say that read A operation is executing after receiving a value from T1. Okay, so read A variable, so the dirty read is that this one is the dirty read, another dirty read is this one. Now that is read after writing T1. So that is read RA, that read E, intermediate read by after that T1, that means this one. So the sequence is same, T1 to T2. Here sequence is what? For A variable, that is intermediate read, we can write like this way. Okay, the intermediate read is what? This one is the intermediate read and this one is the intermediate read. So first intermediate read, it is what? T1 to T2 by S1, And here also first T1 to T2 by S dash. Similarly, for the RA, this is for the RA. Now another iterability to what? This one, we can say this one. This is for what? From T1 to T2, the B read, intermediate read. So for B also, that is for second intermediate read, it is T1 to T2 in S, and T1 to T2, it is in S dash also. Okay, so initial read by this one, first T1 for A variable, first T1 for B variable. Here also, first S dash for T1 for A variable, T1 for B variable. Final write, A for A, it is T2 variable, for B it is T2 variable. In this case also, final write, it is T2 variable, it is T2 variable. Intermediate read from T1 to T2, from T1 to T2 for the A variable. Intermediate read for B variable from T1 to T2, from T1 to T2. Okay, that means what? S and S dash both are view equivalent. View equivalent. Okay, both are view equivalent, and we can see S dash is a serial schedule. This is what our serial schedule. We can see. So first execute T1, then execute T2. So it is serial schedule, and both are view equivalent. That means we can say this particular schedule, it is view serializable. So S is view serializable. It is because it is view equivalent to the other serial schedule S dash. Okay, now we have seen our chart. Now in concurrency, there are two types, serializable. In serializable, there are conflict serializable and view serializable. And from this serializable, we can check whether it is concurrent, whether it will produce consistent result or not. Now that means if it is a conflict serializable, then definitely it will produce consistent schedule. It's a consistent schedule. Now, if a transaction is conflict serializable, that means it is both conflict serializable and view serializable. And we can see view serializable is somewhere here. Okay. And if a transaction is conflict serializable, that means automatically it is view serializable. But if it is a view serializable, that means not it is a conflict serializable. Okay. If you are here, that means it is a view serializable but not conflict serializable. And if it is conflict serializable or view serializable, definitely it should be the consistent. Definitely it should be the consistent. So if a schedule is somewhere here, so it is neither conflict serializable nor view serializable, but it may be possible that it is consistent. But if you are here, that means it is a view serializable as well as consistent, but not conflict serializable. But if it is here, that means it is all conflict serializable, view serializable, as well as consistent. Okay. Next, we'll discuss checking whether a schedule is view serializable or not. We have to check whether it is view serializable or not. So we may follow some path. Say first of all, we have to check whether it is conflict serializable or not. Okay, because directly checking the view serializable is a time consuming process. Okay, it is a very time inefficient process to check whether it is a view equivalent or not. So first of all, you have to check whether it is conflict serializable or not using the precedence graph, just we have discussed in the last video. And if it is a conflict serializable, that means automatically it is view serializable. Okay, no issue. Now we can check. Now if it is not conflict serializable, that means what? It is here, somewhere here. So if it is the case, then no issue. Now if it is here, that means what? It is not conflict serializable. Now if it is not conflict serializable, we have to check if any blind write is there or not. So if blind write is there, then schedule may be view serializable. And if the blind write is not there, then it is not view serializable. Okay. Now say the blind write is not there. Then we have to check each and every stage using the three conditions. Now we have discussed about these three conditions. So we have to see each and every conditions, and we have to see each and every initial read, final read, and intermediate read. and we have to from this particular we have to check each and every steps, each and every instructions, and after that we can say whether it is view serializable or not. So first is what we check whether it is conflict serializable or not. If it is conflict serializable, definitely. If it is conflict serializable, then definitely it is also view serializable. Now if it is not, if it is yes, if it is not, then we have to check blind write is there or not. If blind write is there, yes. If it is yes, then definitely it is view serializable. If it is no, then it may or may not be the view serializable. Then we have to check the third method. We have to check the initial final initial read, okay, final write and intermediate read. We can see one example. Check whether it is a view serializable or not. So first of all, we have to check whether conflict serializable or not. Now what you can do, we have to draw a precedence graph, already you know. So we have to draw a precedence graph. So read A and write A, both are conflict operations. So first I have to execute T1, then T2. Okay, similarly T1 and T3 both are conflict, read and write on same variable A. So first T1, then T3. Next this one, so T2 T1 both are conflicting, so T2 to T1, T2 to T3 it is also conflicting, T1 to T3 it is conflicting. So cycle is there, that means it is not conflict serializable. Okay, so it is not conflict serializable. Then we have to check whether blind write is there or not. Now we can see here one blind write is there. Okay, so blind write is there, that means it may be possible that it is a view serializable. Now we can check is dash is a is similar type of that, read a, write a, wa and wa. Now we can see this is a serial schedule. We can see it is a serial schedule. Now we have to check the initial read by T1. So initial read of A by T1 in S, and here also initial read by T1 in S dash. Final write of A is what? Final write of A variable by T3 in S, and here in T3 in S dash also. And any intermediate read, there is no intermediate read. Okay, that means what? S and S dash both are view equivalent, and S dash is what? It is serial. That means we can say both are view serializable. Okay, now you can see another example. Say two transactions are there, T1 and T2. So T1 and T2, and we can see read A and B. So the variables are different. W and B, the variables are different, so they are not conflicting. Read B, read B not conflicting, read B and write B it is conflicting. So you have to execute T2 first, then T1, and for this WB they are conflicting with this one as well as this one, same, and this after that there is no instructions. So this is what precedence graph of this particular schedule, and we can see there is no cycle present. That means what? This schedule is what? It is conflict serializable. So if it is conflict serializable, that means what? It is also, if it is conflict serializable, it is also view serializable. Okay, now final example, say another schedule is there, say T1, T2, two transactions are there, T1 and T2. Okay, so read A, write A, they are conflicting, T1 to T2. Write A, conflicting, T1 to T2. Then WA and read A, T2 to T1, they are conflicting. So definitely cycle is there, that means what? This is not conflict serializable. Now here blind write is there, that means it may be possible that it is view serializable. Now you can see one serial schedule, say similar type of that, read a write a, this one, read a write a. Okay, now we have to check the three condition, initial condition. So for a variable initial read is what? By t1 in by s schedule and s dash, it is also by t1 a variable. Okay, and the final write, it is T2 variable, here it is T2 variable. So final write for this is what initial read, final write of the variable a. It is by t2. It is also by t2. Now we have to check the intermediate read. Now we can see here one intermediate read is there. So it is what t2 to t1. Okay. So intermediate read. So this is what initial read, intermediate read. It is what here it is in A's, it is t2 to t1. T2 to t1. But here it is intermediate read is what? It is what? It is t1 to t2. It is t1 to t2. Okay. That means what? It is not follow, it is not the same. This, it is the violation of this third second rule. Okay. That means this both they are not view equivalent. Okay. So though it is a serial schedule, but this is not view serializable. And that is the topic for today's video. Thank you very much.